Hey, Mooney, how are you?
This is my son's dog. His name's Mooney. He likes to sit out here in the shop and hang out with me when I'm working. All right, so it is production diary number 2 on my short film, A Goblin's Tale. That's the working title anyway. Today I am about to finish, let me show you guys, a second armature. Here's all the parts. I got some feet, I got a torso right here, and some knees and all that stuff. I need basically 2 elbows right here. I need to make 2 joints with a piece of brass rod attached. So the elbows are actually, let's call it a single ball joint compared to like these, which are like a double ball joint. So double ball just means it has 2 balls, and single ball is a ball and is connected firmly to this other side. Why this makes sense for elbows is, for one thing, you can hook this nice brass rod on here that can accept, you know, a hand. And so the hands can be replaced, like if you have a hand that's like a fist, or if you have a hand that's holding like a sword, you can just pull off the hand and then put on the new hand. Just works well. And also hands break. The wires and fingers break a lot. So it's just good to make a system where you can replace the hands easily. The other reason is this is more like a real elbow. If you look at your own elbow, it bends like that. It does turn and stuff, but it doesn't turn like the shoulders turn, or the torso, like the back. But your elbows are a little different. Your elbows, you know, they work like this. They do like move like this, but not quite so much. As like this. They're more like a hinge, like a door opening and closing. So anyway, you could make it out of a double joint if you wanted, but you know, if you make it out of a single, it's more human acting and just makes animating easier. So anyway, let's make one. Let's go ahead and make one. I'm going to start with some 5/16, just steel rod that I buy at the hardware store. Or actually, let's make 4 of them, because I need elbows on the next puppet, so I might as well just go ahead and, you know, make a set of 4, so that I have, you know, I can finish out this puppet and I can actually get a start on the next puppet. So let's go ahead and cut some 1-inch pieces. Let me show you this. Each one of these has to have this sort of little ridge on it. This kind of thing. See what I mean? And then basically, this screw tightens down. It holds the back of this real tight. This screw is kind of like your tension. So, and then there's like a ball and a rod sticking out here. Like that. And so you need this little piece right here. So I need to grind like a small, I don't know what you call it, the shelf, I guess. I need to grind a little shelf, like right here, on each one of these pieces of bar here. I went ahead and marked this, like this way, using my calipers, and then I know from like the previous armatures, like the width I'm going for needs to be about 1.5, and that seems to work well. So it's kind of like that measurement right there, as you can see, is about 1.5. And then I just try to roughly grind that down in that shape. Oh, there we go. That's what it came out like. It's a little rough right now, but I'll sand it up and it'll look real pretty. So then that plate can just fit right on there like that. All right, let's get four more of those. So there's four matching pieces. Pretty good. Now I need to drill the holes. So basically I stick one of the plates right on there as tight as I can. And then I use this punch, which is just a really hard piece of sharp metal. And I just kind of center it in there and make kind of a hole. And then hit it with a hammer. So this gives me, you know, a nice little thing for my bit to grab onto. It won't walk all over the place. And then I usually just take my calipers like this, and I just kind of run them across there like that. And that leaves a nice little scratch. So then when I come back and I have the bolt through there, when I have the hole drilled and the bolt through there, and I need to drill this second hole, then I know where that hole needs to be. So this needs to be a 3/16 bit, this first hole. So here is one of the plates, and I need to drill out these two holes at 3/16, these two on the back here. So I buy the plates, and I love them. They work great, but unfortunately, this is kind of some of the stuff I was talking about in the other video where the holes aren't what I need. You know, they work for the way they do their armatures, but like for the way I do my armatures, I just don't dig them. So I go ahead and I drill out these two holes at 3/16 each. And on the other side, so there's going to be a plate on the other side like that. And then I'll drill out the two holes again, and I will tap them. I will tap them at like 8/32, so that these bolts are 8/32, which is what I like to use. I like to be consistent. I don't like 100 different bolts and 100 different threads and 14 different taps and all that kind of stuff. That gets even more complex. So basically, this is the kind of the conclusion I've come to, is just to drill out the holes and retap them the size that I want. So these holes are real nice, easy to drill because there's a nice pilot hole to go through. All right, so now come back over here. This is the plate that I drilled out. Let me throw a bolt through. It goes right through there. So now I'm going to hold it really tight and steady and use my punch right here and just do the same thing. Put it in the hole and punch a mark in the exact spot that'll be nice and tight and like a perfect fit. But I can't do that one-handed, so I'm going to do that off camera. Here it is, and it fits. But I want to show you guys something else. Now that I've got this hole drilled, you can't actually get two screws side by side. You see they hit. Their heads are too big. This is another one of those finicky things I was talking about. So like the screw heads don't fit, right? Because of where the holes are drilled. Now I could just make my own parts and, you know, drill my holes in the right spot. But, you know, it does save time having the plates made. I mean, it's kind of nice to just be able to make or buy the plates. And they're pretty cheap. So, basically what I do is I grind down the heads of the bolts. So, basically, I take a bolt and I just put it into my drill. I know that it needs to be this much. And then I just turn my drill on, grab my grinder, and I got the right size head on the bolt. And we got two bolts side by side. And they still work and everything. Like, even though I ground down the outside, you know, the inside is still there. Focus up, camera. And can be turned and works fine. Okay, now I have four of these. And now what I need to do is take these plates and have them so they'll screw on. So for that, I need to drill and tap these two back holes to accept an 8/32 bolt. So the main thing you want to do is you just want to be straight. So once I put this thing in here, like in this configuration, I don't take it out. So I'll drill the holes and then I'll put the tap in and then get it started and then loosen up the chuck, pull the tap out, and then finish it off by hand. And that's just to make sure that the tap goes through straight. So once you get the two holes drilled, now the joint is going to fit like this, right? See how that hole right there is like way behind this little edge of steel? In other words, the ball, you know, needs to be right there because it's going to be out here moving, right? So I left like too much steel here because I didn't want to drill a hole like right there with that much left. You know, that would have been really almost impossible for me. I'm sure some other, you know, genius engineer could have done it, but not me. So what I do is now I grind this back. I just go ahead and I take this metal off. Now that ball can be right there. Let's put it together. And there you go. See how it works? We're not done yet because we need to still get a piece of brass rod attached to this back end. So what I usually do is just freehand grind this square. It's pretty easy, and I'll just kind of show you guys as I go. I think it's about ready to go. So I just need a little bit more. Okay, there you go. That's how that'll go. Now I'll drill a hole. I'll drip a pin in there. I'll solder it. So before you solder, you always want to give everything a good sand. Get it down to like bare metal. You don't want any oil or anything that's going to inhibit the solder from sticking. This is the flux I use, which is silver solder flux, lead free. And the solder I like to use is silver solder. The silver solder just sticks a bit better. It works better when you're soldering, you know, non-like metals. So I got brass, I got steel. So anytime you're doing something like that, you want some kind of solder that's really going to work well. So this flux, for whatever reason, is like very watery. As you can see, I'm going to put a couple dabs down in there. Which at first I didn't really dig it. I was kind of like, no, this ain't good. I like that paste type stuff that I usually would get. Like when you're doing a copper pipe or something. But over time, it's just grown on me. And I like it because it's like, it fits everywhere. It kind of sinks in everywhere. The way I like to solder stuff is to actually cut little pieces off like this. Let me cut like three of them. And then I'll just take each piece and I'll just set it up here. Just like that. If you got some little tweezers, then you don't have to mess around with your big fingers. So that's how it's looking. I might have a little bit more. I don't know if I need this piece out on the end. But that hole's decently big. And I also want the solder to flow completely around this joint. And I also do a little flux on top of these pieces. I try to get it well fluxed, you know, like that seems to be the key to soldering because I'm not a pro at it and I've always actually been kind of bad at it. but like clean metal, dry metal for sure, which we don't have that problem here. And also a lot of like the flux so that, you know, it keeps everything from burning that you don't want to burn. And also it lets the solder flow where it's going to flow, right? So let's do it. This is just a normal propane torch. You want to heat up around the joint. So you want to heat this and let the heat sink in. You want to heat this and let the heat sink that way. And then when the heat gets to the solder, it'll melt it. You don't want to put it right on the solder. So I'm going to put a little bit on the brass. Of course, the steel's going to take longer. I'm just going to keep it there. There it goes, there it goes, there it goes. You see it? It's just sucked right down in there. I'm just going to heat that a little bit more just in case I didn't quite get it. You can see that smoke, and you don't want to breathe that. Silver solder smoke, just the whole bit. Probably should have had my mask on. You don't want to breathe it. It's not good for you. But we'll let that cool off for a second, and then we'll see how I did. So there you go. You can see the solder came out real good. Filled that up. It went all the way around. And that's what you want. Okay, so there's four of those. And now all I got to do is assemble, put the puppet together. Or at least the armature, right? I think I'll do that next week, though, because I know this video is getting long. I'll see you guys next time. Subscribe, like, unsubscribe. I can't help but say it because I just think it's hilarious. Unsubscribe if you don't like me. Or even if you do, unsubscribe and then resubscribe. That'll really fuck with YouTube. And then also dislike. Definitely hit some dislikes. See you guys next time.